I think I've always been the kind of guy who likes the unexpected, who can think on their feet. I like the kind of strategic challenges. I like the innovation that it comes with. And so that's been my career choice. So doing this has been really part and parcel of my makeup. So it was quite a task initially. And 8 years ago, 10 years ago, was a huge mission because there weren't many people out there who could do that kind of thing. But what we didn't realize was that in fact, we couldn't pre-plan any stage. We could only pre-plan the first stage. Looking at what we take with us, we have kind of become a field hospital rather than just, you know, an emergency center as such. And in fact, in many instances, what we take with us is more than most emergency departments have for their regular operation. In most instances, a 20-bed emergency center would be attached to a major academic hospital, so something of the likes of Groote Hospital. Our endeavor is really to make sure that every one of the 600 odd teams that gets onto the finish line in the morning is in the best possible shape they can be for their day. Whether that means from the perspective of their saddle sores, which many cyclists actually do develop, or whether it's electrolyte imbalance, or whether it's wounds, or whether it's joint rescue that we need to do, whatever the case may be, that the mission is really to ensure that we can patch them up on the day before and make sure that on the next day that they're back on the finish, on the start line rather, in as good a shape as we're likely to get them. There's the science behind mountain biking and the injuries and the illnesses associated with it. That's still in its infancy in terms of the way we're investigating it, the way we research it, the way we understand it. Every single congress that there is in emergency medicine that touches on sports medicine asks, you know, when are we going to present some of the data? So that's probably going to be my next big challenge. Once we've stabilized the operational platform and we've got a good system running with good data that we capture every year, that we can actually use that data to analyze what we do, how we do it, and how good it is for people. I think for me, the most essential item is really to be able to have a pillow that I can put my head down on at night for the 4 or 5 hours and get proper restful sleep. I will never ride the Epic. I don't think I ever will. But trust me, every single year, it feels like I have ridden the Epic because pretty much out with the cyclists every day out there, and you know, vicariously we feel their pain, there's no question about it. So I do think that we've had an intense experience. I just won't be pedaling.